My name is Thorsten Aargaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world taking photographs and teaching photography. Today I will tell about a small camera bag that you can use for walkabout, basically walk around with all day. So today I want to talk about a bag that is easy, like this one, to walk around with, and you just have it here. This is my own mini messenger bag that I will tell about. I have an obsession with bags. I have loved to buy bags for many years, for any occasion, any excuse I can find to buy a bag. I've done it, Gucci, Louis Vuitton, Hermes, Goyard, everything, I've been there. So no wonder I started making my own bags, and one of the reasons I did it was that I travel a lot, so I have my suitcases, but I also have my cameras and I have my computer. So how do I, that have to be carry-on, I'm not going to check in cameras. So one thing I did was I made the one camera bag. It's this one, and this one I basically made 3 years ago, but we didn't put it into production until a year later. What we did first, we made one for me and I used it and abused it, and then we made it into a production in blue, black, brown and what have you, different colors. This one is not a walkabout bag. It does have a shoulder strap, but the idea is not you're going to walk around with this one. This one does fit a lot of equipment, and you could say the idea of this one is that it has some pockets inside for fillers and business cards and what have you, and it has space for extra space for a jacket, and here you have like a light meter. The idea with this one is that you pack it, and maybe you even store, that's what I do, you actually store your camera system at home in it, and then when you travel you can put this insert into the bag. You could also put this into a Fendi bag or another bag. So in here you have space, let's just take all the stuff out, you have space for film, a couple of cameras with or without lenses here. I can actually be packed four like end cameras without lenses. Chargers, extra lenses, and more extra lenses. Oh, and a couple of more extra lenses. And this way you can just change around. So the way I use this one, and this one by the way, say here, always wear a camera. It's my brand, and this is even a luxury insert. Because I like things that are well made and last a long time and really works. So everything I do is very simple, and it's made to travel a lot, so it's not going to fall apart or start looking weird. The point with this one is when I travel, I put it in a car or I take it with me as a carry-on in an airplane, and when I get to a hotel or house or wherever I get, I park this bag in the house or my new home, and then I pack the stuff I need to take with me. And what I need is basically just one camera. So to illustrate this, I'm gonna clear out the table here. It's like a casino with all this stuff. When I walk around in the city, I basically just need one camera, and usually what I do is I just put it across my shoulder here, and then I can have it on the back, I can have it here, I can have my hands free, and I don't have to wonder if I'm going to drop the camera or what. If it's there, I can still feel it, and it's ready when I want to take a photo, and I can just drop it again. So often I don't need any extra space, but then again, you walk around New York for a whole day, you need an extra battery, you need a filter, maybe there's another lens you want to try, maybe you have a monochrome camera you also want to try, maybe you want to buy something and still have your hands free, so you have to put it somewhere. And that's how the mini messenger came about. This one is also one I used for 2 years as a prototype, and then we made the final one. And before I show what I have in this one and what fits in it and how it works, is I'll just show there's a lot of simplicity going into this one. Like one thing, it has a shape so it folds around your body. So that means if you carry this bag and it's empty, you're not going to feel it. If you put a little bit in it, you're going to feel a little bit. And if you try to take any big lightweight camera bag or any big bag with nothing in it and put it across your shoulder and walk around for a day, you're actually going to be really tired by just the size and the movement of it. So that's part of the secret, is the size that it slings around the body. Then it has a white strap here that is soft And you can see it doesn't have any metal things or anything here. The only adjustment it has is over here. And this is actually one we did that it locks in this one. You can adjust it here. So it locks here because my prototype would actually work its way out. So that's why we did this lock. It has some hand-painted orange edges just to make it look nice. And then this one have a secret pocket on the back. So this is where you could put, I have here a lens clot. I have a phone here. So sometimes papers, whatever, chewing gum, you decide what you want to put where. This one I'm just going to show because this one I actually use a lot also without the camera. So this one, I have a couple of notebooks in it. I have some pens. I have my wallet. I have some chewing gum. I have ink for my Mont Blanc pen. It's just that shows how eccentric I am, but I have it. I have a charging cable for my phone, and oh, I have one more polishing cloth, and then I have a extra battery. Oh, and also have a lens hood here. So this is kind of like all the small things that it's nice to have with you, but you may not need them, but it's nice. So this one I will actually use a lot. I'll just stick in a 16-inch computer in this one, and it sticks up a little bit, and I close it so it sits like this if I have to walk from the car to a cafe or just down the street or something like that. But mostly I'll have notebooks or small things in it. And you can say if I walk around New York for a day and I can't really decide what to do, I mean, you could say, yeah, my wallet goes into it. My phone I can put here instead of a pocket. I need some pens. And then I can put a camera in. Let's just put the big camera here with a lens. So I can put this one in it. I could actually put also, for example, this 90mm over here, but I would be a little bit concerned about scratches, so maybe I'll just roll this one around. And that's very much my thinking. There's no soft insert in this because that would make the bag unusable for other things, and it also makes it complicated. You don't need it. This is Alcantara. It's really nice and soft. You're almost like polishing the camera when you walk with it. And if you want to put things together that could scratch each other, then you wrap it in something. It's not a big deal. And then now you have an extra camera bag. So it's a very, you could say it's a flexible bag, and it's meant for both men and women. It looks really nice. One of the ideas I had for this size bag was that I'm going to show this very rare Louis Vuitton binocular bag. It's really a piece of beauty. the only thing with this one is that it doesn't like rain. It can't take rain on this, and it gets scratched, and it's like terribly expensive and very limited edition, but it's kind of a cool bag. With less space than this one, it actually weighs more. I had others. I had a Goyard bag similar to this one that they stopped making. Those ones are like 3,000 secondhand now. They actually went up in price after they stopped making them. And I make them in brown like this one. And I also do a black, which this was the brown one. I'm just gonna show you. This is how it comes from. It's handmade in Italy. So the artisans that sit and make this have been doing this for generations. And I specified how I want it, and they use all the tricks they know in the book, how to do the stitching so it looks right and all this stuff. And here you have the black 1mm ready to wear. And we also do in blue, and we will do other colors, probably brown and stuff, but right now you can get them in brown. I really mean it. The way I make products is I make things that how I want them, and if nobody else makes them and they don't, you cannot buy Hermes or Louis or any bag that is made this lightweight and simple as this one for what I use it for, and it can stand all the travel. So what I do is I have my own stuff made first and I test it, and when I like it, then that's how I use it, and I also make it available. So yeah, it's a business, but it's also trying to help other people to get the right thing. So it is for you if you appreciate something that lasts a lifetime and is the optimum quality. You can't get anything made in this quality anywhere else. So that's what I do. The 1mm, that's all I had to say today. I will say one more thing is if you go below the video, there's a link to the back, of course, but you go below the video, there's a link to my website, and you go sign up for a mailing list and you get a free ebook, and you can also get a free online photography masterclass. That's all I had to say. Till I see you next time, thank you for watching, and always wear a camera.